Hi everybody, welcome back to my floor. Don't let the clickbait title and thumbnail fool you. I'm actually quite excited about what we're going to do today. Many of you perhaps don't know this about me, but I am a water sign. Actually, I'm a double water sign, and that means that through several phases throughout my life, I have become obsessed with mermaids. I was that little girl that was obsessed with going swimming when I was a little girl, and I would play with my friends at the pool. We would pretend to be mermaids. I would often fantasize as a teenager about just joining sea life and becoming a mermaid and living in the ocean. Let me share with you some mermaids. Hold on. Okay, so the first thing I want to share with you is actually this cute little art piece that I picked up in, I think, Assateague, if any of you know where that is. I went to Assateague with my ex-husband once, and we had a very beautiful vacation there, and someone was selling these gorgeous handmade curvy mermaids, and I thought she was so beautiful I had to bring her home. She's got a very long, sparkly tail, and it's just an ornament that you hang. I have it hanging on a shelf that's over there. I just love her. I think she's beautiful, so, you know, my love of mermaids has bled into the various knickknacks that I have in the home. Okay, this next thing that I want to show you is actually an unfinished art piece of yore. So, once upon a time I used to be really into embroidery, and I actually completed one of these that I eventually gifted to a friend of mine. I'll be able to post a picture up on screen so that you can see the previous one that I finished. This one looks a little bit more janky than that one, but I used to do these embroidery mermaids, and the proportions on this one don't look that great. But the one thing that I am super proud of, here, let me move my camera over here, actually. Yeah, that's better. That's way better with the light. So you can actually see that I have, first I filled in her tail, and then I came over it to do the scales in metallic thread, which was, oh my gosh, so very difficult. I can't tell you how long I labored on these projects, and then tried to create this beautiful head of hair using a technique called, it's not couching, is it? I can't remember what it's called now, but it's an embroidery technique. Again, something to post up on the screen later so that you can leave these long strands. And if I show you what the original finished mermaid that I had given to my friend Nicole is, there is this really cool trick that I used to do where I would style the hair using a little bit of PVA glue and water and a hair dryer, and you know, you like curl the hair around, I think it was the end of a paintbrush that I used, something very slim like this, and I could make these beautiful long flowing locks of mermaid hair. And this was something that I was really into for a really long time, embroidery in general, but I loved making these. I thought they were really fun. Oh my god. Would you look at the kidder? I need this. Can I have this back? can I have this back, please? Oh my god. Listen, can you get up, please? Oh my god. This cat, I swear to god. No! She's trying to climb on it. Not everything is a bed for you. This is where I store my mermaid. All right, I'm done goofing around now. So without further ado, I think it is time that I finally create a mermaid piece before the end of May. I think that's kind of the whole point of me making this video today. While I am fond of looking on other people's creations during these long, intensive art challenges like Mermay, Inktober, Huvember is another one, I love absorbing what other people have completed, but I myself do not ever find myself motivated to pursue art challenges that require you to complete the same kind of art or a style of art, whatever, for 30 days in a row. That sounds so exhausting to me, so I instead am just going to pay tribute to Mermay by creating a mermaid with all of you today. And I have a hard time with transitions. Let's do it. Let's paint a mermaid. Alright, good morning! These are still here for some reason. I'll just leave them over there. So I am kind of excited. I haven't drawn or created any artwork mermaid related for an incredibly long time. What's wrong with- oh, it's got another clip inside it. I was wondering what happened to this little guy. I was hiding it from myself. So I have to look at some pictures on my phone that I'm going to pull up as reference here. So just give me a moment here to find out which of these lovely humans I want to translate into a mermaid today. So I'm gonna try to make this figure kind of big. Let's start with the human side because that's the part that's a little bit the most familiar to me. Should I erase it? Should I start over? Do I even need a reference image? See, the problem that I have with me trying to draw things when I don't use reference is that I haven't yet figured out how to make my drawings not look super stiff. Like, my figures always end up looking like, you know, those wooden or like silicone posing modeling dolls? Like that, but worse. I don't want to limit myself, you know what I mean? I think it's important to continue to improve in whatever way you can, and sometimes that means taking risks. And sometimes those risks mean that you are going to create art that you think is fugly. How many people have said the word fugly unironically in the year 2021? Is it just me? Now the only question I have for myself is, do I want to ink this before I put some paint down? Here's a question for all of you at home. Do mermaids have belly buttons? That is the ultimate question. Because sometimes I feel the need to draw a navel on a mermaid, but then I'm like, are they mammals or are they not? Are they fish? This is the ultimate question. This is the thing that keeps me up at night. I have to know. Do mermaids gestate their babies as mammals do, or do they lay eggs? Would either of those things contribute to having or not having a belly button? I feel like it's an existential question. Any mermaids out there? Can you weigh in? I'm actually a fan of this drawing, and I think I do want to ink it. I want to ink at least the mermaid, because I want to add some background elements too. She's in water, obviously, so I want to make sure that there are some maybe like fish and things sort of floating in the background. I think it would look a little bit better, and like they're out of focus, sort of like in the sea in the background. I think that would look pretty cool. The reason I haven't created any delineation between her skin and the scales of her tail here is because I kind of like it when that's more of like a subtle effect as opposed to, I think there's a trope when people draw mermaids that they need to have a belt. But yeah, there's always like this belt of sorts that sort of delineates the human flesh from the fishy scales below. And I think that that is the funniest thing that I've ever seen, and it, I don't know why, but it bothers me. I like it so much better when there's like this very subtle transition from one into the other. It feels more natural to me for whatever reason, so I'm gonna try to attempt doing that.
I just ate a sandwich.
Okay, we're back. All right, so developments. I decided that I was gonna put some masking fluid on my mermaid, and by some masking fluid I mean like a whole crap ton of masking fluid. It was an accident for the most part, especially up in the up here region. What I had intended to do was only mask around the edges, that way that I didn't accidentally bleed onto the mermaid figure herself. There was a moment where I took this like crummy old brush that I used to do my masking and I dipped it into the pot of masking fluid and picked up this giant glob, and it kind of like splatted right in the middle of her face, so I was just like, okay, and I filled the whole thing in. And this should be, I guess, dry by now. It's still kind of tacky, but I think that
that's fine.
Made a choice to use watercolor. I'm gonna use my Mio watercolors for this just because I have a really good color range here. And I really like some of the blues that I have, so I thought I'd start there. But also, I decided that for this project, I am also going to whip out the metallic set of Paul Rubens watercolors again to jazz up the scales on her tail and such. I thought that would be a really cool use of this particular watercolor palette. And I did want to use this watercolor palette on white paper or on a non-black surface, I should say. So we'll revisit this in a moment, but let's get some water up here. Let's pull out the giant Hemi brush that I'm so fond of. Let's give it a good soak in this water. I wanted the freedom to get messy with this one, just for the water in the background, because water is so flowy, you know what I mean? Oh, I just realized I missed a spot with the masking fluid. Let's just be a little extra careful in that area. Masking fluid, we're doing art projects with masking fluid. If you guys haven't realized by now that I'm an absolute dork and I like to like break into song every once in a while, where have you been? All right, so we've got a very white mermaid and a blue background. So I think it's now time to add some color to this character. Now, I love when fantasy characters have like a very, what do you call it, like fantasy skin tone, because I want to give this mermaid kind of purple skin, kind of? I don't know. We're gonna start with just a very watered down purple, this like really pretty light violet color, which I guess leaves me to wonder what color I should use for her tail. Okay, so my two favorite colors are purple and green, and I really wanted to incorporate some green into this mermaid. I really love this like olive green color that's up here. How about that? I really like that so far. And then, of course, I want the end of her tail to also contain some purple. Oh no, look at that splotch. Oh god, this watercolor paper is such a bastard. Damn this book. Ah, it's so irritating. It is nice though to do a different kind of watercolor painting, something that's a little bit more illustrative, cartoony. I don't really like that word. I think it sounds kind of goofy, but you know what I mean. I think I lean so heavily on realism sometimes that it's just nice to try something different. And then I am gonna do her hair green also, starting out with a very light shade of green. I do want to add kind of like a more rosy color. That's pretty nice. And then usually I go for like a cooler shadow, but because we have such a cool skin tone with this purple, we're gonna have to get a little inventive. I'm thinking maybe one of these blues. Oh my god, that looks so dark. I'm trying to make it look as if she doesn't have a 5 o'clock shadow now. Not that there's anything wrong with that, I suppose, but that wasn't the look I was going for. While we're working on this, I do kind of want to bring in a nice deep purple for her lips, and we can work on the hair a little bit more. I want a nice dark green for her eyebrows. Oh god, I really hate this. Like, I'm trying not to, but I do. I hate it. What's happened? What has happened? Oh, I'm ruining it. No. Wow. I'm so angry. I really liked this drawing too. God, is there any way to salvage this? I feel like I'm just making it worse.
I'm having a crisis.
I really wanted this to look lovely and soft and pretty, and it's just not. I think the mistake that I made
is once again trying to like do a very tiny portrait. Also maybe trying to get a little bit too fancy. I'm not really sure. I am just so upset about her face, so. Poor thing.
It looks so muddy.
I hate this. I do, I hate this. I hate how I ruined a good drawing by
painting badly.
I'm a bad artist today. Is there any way I can salvage this? Like, every time I try, I feel like I just make it worse. Okay, well, I'm just gonna move on now. I wonder if the Paul Rubens paints can actually, like, salvage this at all. Yeah, this is gross. I don't know why I'm continuing with this. Okay, progress report. Yeah, I don't like this. I don't like this. I don't like anything about this, except for maybe the drawing that I did. The drawing is still nice, but I cannot believe how belly up this painting has gone, honestly, from the moment I started. It's just, I can't get good contrast. I'm not a fan of some of my color selections. It sounded or looked better in my imagination before I started it than when I put it down on paper. I am the kind of person that is so much a perfectionist that if I don't like the result of what I'm doing, I will kind of half-ass my work. So the tail doesn't look right, the scales don't look right, the hair kind of looks jacked up, and I want to give up. I really do. This is definitely out of my comfort zone, and I was trying to proceed and soldier on, like, oh, I can make it work, I can make it work, and then the longer I worked on it, the more it looked messed up to me, and now I just don't even want to continue, and I want to work on something else. I guess now would be a good time for me to sort of address some of my artistic insecurity around this, because I have this horrible fear that people won't think that I'm a legitimate artist unless I can draw and execute something perfectly without using a reference. And that makes me feel very deeply insecure, because it's almost like that's my crutch. I need to have that in front of me in order for me to make art that's halfway decent, because where my talent lies and where my skill set lies is in replicating from a picture onto paper. I'm very good at that. Not so good at doing stuff like this from imagination without any help. And like her face, it just looks so muddy. I hate it so much. I tried really hard to like kind of brighten it up a little bit with the metallic watercolors, but you can't even see it until you tilt it, and then it just looks very strange. And if it weren't for the fact that last week's project, this painting right here, was on the underside of this paper, I would be ripping this thing out of my out of my watercolor sketchbook. I'm tempted to just, like, draw a big nasty X over it. Now, I know what you're gonna say. I'm sure some of you are gonna be like, oh, Serena, it looks fine. It looks beautiful. What are you talking about? You are welcome to have that opinion. I'm not gonna argue with you if you think it looks good, but I need to think it looks good. Me. Me. I need to think it looks good. And unfortunately, if you think it looks good, then I just simply cannot agree with you. It's just a matter of personal taste. Okay, I've come back to this after adding a little bit more, and, well, unfortunately, I still don't really like it. I tried my best. Now that I've had a chance to cool off a little bit, I don't think it's as embarrassing as I originally thought. I still don't like it. I think she looks a little bit too ghostly. I don't like the hair. I think that after a while it just became very evident that it was unsalvageable in the way that I wanted it to be salvaged. So we have here on this side another drawing that I did, this time from reference. So I really like the way her hands came out too. And what I'm going to attempt to do and pray that I don't screw up this time. Oh dear God. Because there's really only so much time this week that I can devote to doing mermaids. I just wanted to give this one more go around with this cute drawing. I like this drawing a lot better than the previous drawing too. I like the pose. I decided to like incorporate sort of a beach scene. So she's sort of lying on the shoreline. She's got her tail sort of very, you know, flipped behind her in a very flirty fashion. And I like the way her face looks. So we're going to go with this.
Okay, real talk. Just because I feel like I owe you guys my honesty. Not that I haven't been honest in the past or anything, but the thing is that I don't want to just like edit out things just because I don't like them. I feel like that would be a poor representation of me and of the artistic struggle, frankly, because doesn't everybody eventually go through this at some point where you try art and you find it utterly unsatisfying? So if I could put my ego aside and just let y'all know that occasionally I do have a little bit of a tantrum whenever certain things don't necessarily go my way, when my insecurities are revealed, maybe it would be a benefit to someone to see like someone like me who's been doing art for years and feels like I'm pretty decent at my particular skill, that occasionally you just have a bad art day. You just can't do the thing the way that you had originally intended to. Sometimes it looks like absolute crap, no matter how much you try to save it. And you just gotta move on. You just gotta work on the next thing. So that's what we're going to do. I'm gonna whip out my paints. We're gonna paint this mermaid. What time is it? Oh gosh, it's already 10 p.m. So I'll probably do it in the morning, but at any rate, I'm gonna get this done, and no matter the outcome, there will be a video, and you're definitely gonna see some mermaids, so wish me luck.
Okay, so as you can see, I had reverted back to the pose that I had originally drawn at the beginning of this video that I had then erased in favor of doing a pose that was not using any reference. And as you can see, this one turned out so much better because I was using reference. And it's not like it's an exact copy of my reference. I definitely took my artistic license here and there to create what I thought was a very attractive mermaid, including making the choice to switch the color scheme around. So instead of green hair and tail and purple skin, it's now the other way around. It's purple hair and tail, green skin, green fin. And I had a reference as well for the beach scene that was sort of the setting where she was sitting. And actually, I think I had a couple of different beach scenes that I was referencing throughout this piece. So I just sort of like custom fit them all together bit by bit until I had created an environment that I thought was better. The other executive decision that I made for this piece was not to line it, which I think ended up making me like the end product a little bit better. I think lining it in the previous piece was a mistake and was one of the reasons why I wasn't a fan of that more cartoony style. And then of course at the end I had to jazz it up with those metallic watercolor paints, and you're going to see in a short moment just how effective they were. They turned out really cool.
Observe the beautiful sparkles, the shiny fish scales, which I was admittedly a little bit haphazard with. They're not sort of all facing the same direction, but I think that's okay, because like, in the grand scheme of things, it looks so good from this angle, but then when you tilt it, oh god, the pop, and that color, that weird color that's called copper in the Paul Rubens metallic set, looks so gorgeous on her tail. I even threw a little bit in her hair just for some extra shine. Oh my gosh. And is it even showing up? I did throw some metallic green on her fingernails, but gosh, that's such a tiny portion of this painting, and really it was the hair and the tail that I wanted to look their best. Wow, so pretty. And this is so deeply satisfying after the freaking train wreck that this one was. We're not gonna talk about this one anymore. This one turned out so great, and I'm glad I didn't have to line it. It looks great as it is. I am so happy. So very, very happy. Okay, here I am.
I threw all of my video together and realized I forgot to film an outro, so it's a little unorthodox you seeing me sitting in the editing chair. At any rate, I completed a mermaid painting that I am proud of, and I think I've fulfilled the minimum obligation for Mermay, and I really hope you enjoyed it. If you enjoyed this video and watching me have a breakdown on camera, give me a like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you next week. Take care, everyone. Ciao.